I'll take you on a virtual heritage tour of my city, Nepalganj, where I was born and raised. So, Nepalganj is a city that lies in the Banke district of Lumbini province. It is nearly 525.6 kilometers west from the Kathmandu Valley and nearly 3 kilometers near the Indian borders. The nearest airport that we have in Nepalganj is Mahendra Airport, which is famously known as Rancha Airport or Nepalganj Airport. And this city, if you want to travel to Nepalganj from Kathmandu, it will take around 14 hours by a bus and 1 hour approximately by flight. Nepalganj is a city which is very important when it comes to trade between India and the Western Tarai. Not only it is an important city for the trade in between India and the Western Tarai, there are very few people who know about the history of Nepalganj, how it was created. So back in 1857, when the first Sepoy Rebellion happened in India, Jang Bahadur Rana and his troops actually went and supported the British to crush down the rebellions. And in return, the Britishers allowed the Rana and his troops to enjoy the loot and stay back in the city of Lucknow. That is when Jang Bahadur Rana got an opportunity to explore the city, and he fell in love with Hazratganj, a place in Lucknow. And that's when he decided that I will create my own Ganj in my city, Nepal. And thus Nepalganj was born. After the city was created, now it was the time to populate the city. So for populating the city, various communities from India as well as Nepal were called and invited to settle in the city. And that is when various communities like Thatheers, the one who makes utensils, Sunars, the one who makes the goldsmiths, Potters or Kumhars were actually invited in the city to stay back. And also, after they came into the city, there were certain areas that were defined. Like there is Sunar Mandi where all the goldsmiths reside. There is a Kumhar Toll where all the potters reside. So that is how they separated the areas in the city. And during the civil war that happened in Nepal, the Maoist war, a lot of communities from the western and the far western region of the country actually migrated down to Nepalganj. That is how there is a various diversity of communities living in harmony and living together in a harmonious manner. So in short, we can say that in Nepalganj, the minorities are the majorities, and that is what that makes this city so great. I still remember when I was a kid, when I used to go to school early in the mornings, I could hear the bells from Bageswari Mandir and the azan going on from the Jama Masjid and the chants that were coming out from the Buddhist monastery. It created such a surreal experience. It was something that was defined beyond words. And this diversity of culture can also be seen in the food, of street food especially, of Nepalganj. Various communities has their own flavors and each flavors represent themselves. And this is what we can see on the streets of Nepalganj. And also I would like to mention that the streets of Nepalganj changes its color as the day passes, as the time in the day passes. So for example, in the mornings you'll have chola puri, you'll have samosas, you'll have jalebis, and you'll have the favorite breakfast of Nepalganj, that is chana puri. But in the daytime, you'll find ghamanja. You will not find anything that you found in the mornings. So in ghamanja, it is a combination of various fritters, and it is just explosion in your mouth. It's so flavorful. You must try it if you go there. And then in the evenings, this is the time when the city comes into life. This is the time when you'll actually see the beauty of the city. Various communities will come together, they'll have tea and lunch. You will see the streets of Tribhuvan Chowk and BP Chowk. All these street vendors will come out. They'll sell pani puris, kebab rolls, egg rolls, etc. The food that we enjoy of Nepalganj, it is basically created by the people. And the most important aspect in these foods is that it is created by the women behind. These women are the silent carriers of the tradition and culture. They are the one who hold the thread of this culture and pass down from generations to generation, keeping the authenticity alive. These are the women who are the pillars of making Nepalganj so diverse and culturally rich, and they stay in the background. Back in the times, there were women, they never stepped out of their houses. You would never see women stepping out of the houses, selling things or anything. But now the situation has changed. The women come out of their houses. You will see women vendors. You will see women riding bikes and cycles and rickshaws even. So it is something that we have came so far. But still, there are certain communities we still hold back to the women that they have. And the women are actually made to stay back in their houses. Like, especially the women of Awadhi community or Bhojpuri community, Maithali community, Muslim community, etc. These kinds of women stay back in their houses and they are made to take care of their families and hold on, pass down the traditions, never come out of their houses. And if they have any dream or aspiration of being financially independent or doing something for themselves, they actually have to suppress their vision of it. And while growing up, I saw this same in my family. This lady smiling over there in blue sari, it's my mother, Satyavati Shukla. When she got married, she had this aspiration that she wanted to create something of her own. She didn't know what, but she wanted to create. I saw this helplessness in my mother's eyes where she wanted to create something of her identity, but she could not because she had no support or there were less opportunities or basically she just didn't have the courage to stand up for herself. That is what that inspired me that in future I will start a women-centric business where women like my mother, I could do something for them. And thus the inspiration of my initiative, Satwa Food Products and Katran Nepal came into picture. This is Satwa Food. So along with the women of these communities, I also realized that when I came to Kathmandu for the studies, that is when I realized that a lot of people are still unaware about the communities living in the Tarai region and the flavors and the tradition, culture and arts. They are still in the background. They are not much explored. So I did my research, and after that research, these are the initiatives that I started. So Satwa Food Products basically was started with a vision that the unexplored flavors of Tarai and the community that makes it, we actually try and put forward their flavors in front of the people to learn and explore about it. And we do that by collaborating with the local women and so that they can curate the best flavors. And we source the raw materials from the local farmers of the region. The women are the backbone of Satwa Food Products. They are the one who create magic out of their hands, and they are the one who actually brought us today where we are standing. And the same goes for Katran. Like the food, the art culture of the Tarai is yet unexplored. Katran is working towards bringing out these art forms by helping the women to put forward their upcycling techniques of clothes in front of the world to see and to understand how they do it. So the old textile becomes bags, pouch, or dog beds, etc. We do it either by stitching them in new forms, or we just shred them into smaller pieces so that we can use it as a filling for our dog beds and everything. Or we just cut it in longer strip and then knit it together to make our mats or anything like that. So when I started my journey, the ideas that I had, that was basically out of passion. I was somebody who was just a college graduate and I had a long way to go to learn and explore and actually understand how the world works. So there were times when I had to learn a lot of things on the feet, on the go. There was nobody to actually help me and mentor me. And that is eventually, while I was on this journey, I also got an opportunity to be a part of In Our Hands program, where I got an opportunity to meet with like-minded people with whom I can share my ideas, my vision of future and everything. And that is when I got mentorship from my mentors, who helped me to become who I am today, who gave me the confidence to stand in front of public and speak about whatever I could. They are the ones who actually helped me to reach where I am, because they gave the confidence and they actually made me believe in myself. And that is when And this program also helped me to execute the vision of Katran more effectively. And like I had so many ideas in my head, this was the program that helped me to actually the diversified idea that I had into smaller pictures and actually make it into reality. Still, there are certain challenges I still face. Like the first challenge that I face is lack of financial support. Right now, we don't have a lot of funding opportunities in Nepal, or especially in Nepalganj. And then lack of manpower. If there is someone who is skilled enough, they are not going to stay back in Nepalganj. They'll either move to bigger cities like Kathmandu, Biratnagar, Pokhara, or they'll just go abroad where they can earn more for themselves. And then the other problem that I face is lack of community of like-minded people. I still find, I cannot find proper community where I can go and express myself and learn things, get constructive feedbacks to actually help me improve my work and everything. And the last problem that I feel that everything is Kathmandu centered. It's been 2 years since I have started my entrepreneurial journeys, and throughout I have seen a lot of workshop that is been conducted that I know it will be good for myself, but they are in Kathmandu. If I want to place my products, I have to be in Kathmandu. So I have to just shift the whole logistics, come here and put my stall over here. If I have to talk to certain marts or something, I still have to come to Kathmandu and talk to them. So it acts a way, I'm not complaining about it, but it is just like a step extra for me. So it is a bit difficult. Even though I have a lot of problems and issues and challenges, but these challenges I think I will be able to overcome because I have the commitment of turning my vision into reality. With my initiatives, I believe I will be able to bring out the vibrant art and taste of the Tarai region and put forward in the world to experience. As Mother Teresa famously said, I can do things you cannot, you can do things I cannot, and together we can do great things. So today, taking this opportunity, standing in front of you, I would invite you to be a part of our journey and see our vision and be a part of our adventures and help us grow by your feedbacks, suggestions, inquiries, any kind of queries that you have. This is our contact. You can talk to us anytime you feel like. Thank you so much for this opportunity. And I'm really very grateful for everyone to be here.